Overall, health care spending in New Jersey rose 18% from 2012 to 2016. Spending on prescription drugs jumped 27%, and the actual cost of prescription meds is rising even faster. A new measure would hold the line on costs and impose consequences on companies that don't comply. Raven Santana has the details.
Sometimes one has to determine what is more important.
Gregory Uberto says it's not unusual for some seniors to have to choose between buying medicine or buying groceries. The retired teacher and Vietnam veteran was just one of more than 50 other seniors that voiced their concerns about the rising cost of prescription drugs.
We don't have enough money to pay for the medical drugs that we are getting. If the price goes up, I don't know whether I'll be able to afford it.
According to American Association of Retired Persons, in New Jersey, the average annual cost of prescription drugs rose nearly 58% between 2012 to 2017.
Many drugs are still patented, which means they only offer the one, right? And there's no competition. And those are the drugs that we're worried about.
Which is why Congressman Frank Pallone discussed his H.R. 3, the Lower Drug Costs Now Act, at a public forum at the Long Branch Senior Center. Pallone says the bill would universally lower prescription drug costs by empowering the federal government to negotiate lower prices for those covered by private and public insurance.
The federal government will come up with the 250 name brand drugs for which there's no generic competition, and they will look at the ones that have the highest cost and for which are increasingly unaffordable. And then annually, they'll take at least 25 of those, it could be more, and they will negotiate with the drug companies to bring the price down.
Under the proposed bill, drug companies will not be able to charge customers more than they do in six other countries.
The six countries are Canada, the UK, Germany, France, Australia, and Japan. And essentially what would happen is we take the average cost of, say, one drug from those countries. Drug companies will not be able to have a price that is 1.2 times higher than that, and that is the ceiling at which they will then start the negotiation.
Pallone says the bill also calls for penalties for drug companies that refuse to reduce their prices.
The penalty is 65% of your gross sales, and then it can go up to 95%. So, I mean, it's a huge incentive. I can't imagine anybody's not going to negotiate with the federal government given that penalty.
Currently, the Medicare program does not have an out-of-pocket cap, meaning that patients have no way to know how much they could spend annually on drugs. This bill would also create a new $2,000 out-of-pocket limit on prescription drug costs for Medicare patients. The president and CEO of the Pharmaceutical Research and Manufacturers of America issued a statement on the act. We do not need to blow up the current system to make medicines more affordable. Instead, policymakers should pursue practical policy solutions, such as sharing negotiated savings with patients at the pharmacy counter, lowering coinsurance in Medicare Part D, increasing transparency on patients' costs, among other improvements to the system. Pallone says he's optimistic that the bill will receive Republican support in the Senate after President Trump voiced support for lowering drug prices. In Long Branch, Raven Santana, NJTV News.